From Nashville, Tennessee, it's Country Music Time, brought to you by your local Air Force recruiter and this radio station. Now here's the star of this week's show, Connie Eaton.
Maybe I'm just crazy, or it's something that I just can't explain. I don't know what else I can tell you. Maybe I just like walking in the rain. But if I knew enough to come out of the rain, I wouldn't be here soaking wet in tears again. I'd come under your umbrella like you want me to. You love me, but I love him. What's a girl to do? But if I knew enough to come out of the rain, you'd be the one to warm my heart and ease my pain. Do you want something special? You put me way up there. He uses me, abuses me, but somehow I still care.
Welcome to Country Music Time, Connie Eaton. It's a pleasure having you here.
Thank you very much.
This is the first time you've been on the show in a long, long time, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
And we'll go back just a couple of years when you were 14. And that was and that was kind of the, I guess, sort of the beginning of your musical career. You'd done a little before that, but you were selected as the Park Concert Discovery of the Year by a newspaper here.
They've had it for years here in Nashville. Probably 20 years. It goes way back. And I just auditioned and won it, a little contest.
Well, now, 1968 was, I guess, a really big year for you because you had the you were the winner of the VFW I Speak for Democracy public speaking contest that they had, and you were runner-up in the Miss Nashville Beauty Pageant. I'd sure like to see the winner. And the Best Actress of the Year in Davidson County, and you were also, I guess, at that time, discovered by a record company. That was a great year, I'm telling
really
you. You
ought
to mark that one up on your calendar or something.
Yeah.
When you got out of high school, did you go directly into college at that time?
I went to Lipscomb, David Lipscomb, here in Nashville.
Now, you continued with a lot of acting during that time, did you not?
During that year, as much as I could, but that's when my career was really breaking, and I only completed 1 year.
What's been going on in your life, say, over the past 2 or 3 years?
I decided to make the music business life a little bit more complicated and learn how to write. And I'm beginning to get happy with my work. I know that I'm not anywhere near what I could be if I worked harder, or anywhere near, I know I don't come close to some of the great writers here in Nashville, but I am learning.
Are you going to record some of the songs that you've written?
I would like to. Then again, if I could get a heavy, you know, to cut one of my songs, I sure would be a fool to turn it down.
You said you're learning to write.
Mm-hmm.
And that's something that I'm forever asking people, because to me that's very strange. It's kind of a thing. I can never figure out where you're born with the talent to write, or whether it's actually a thing that, just like English or math or something else, that you actually have to learn to do.
Well, I'm not speaking of myself. Once again, I've observed a lot of writers here in Nashville, and I've been around some of the greatest writers here in Nashville, and understand this is not me that I'm speaking of. But they are born with the talent, but a development period has to occur. Sure, somebody can come into town with a song. I mean, he might look up, the first song he ever wrote was a smash. But then again, there are artists, true artists, who are talented in this field, and they develop. And the publishing companies here in Nashville will invest in them and give them money to just sit at home and write. Isn't that great?
I'd like that kind of a job.
Really?
Myself. Well, I tell you what, I sure am glad that you've decided to get back on the road and do some touring and singing and public appearances and what have you. And I know all your fans are, for sure, as well. And I'd like to hear another one of your songs right now. Can we?
Sure can.
Do you feel the beat talking to your feet? Do you wanna dance? Just reach out your hands. When you're face to face in a new embrace, then the pain is gone, 'cause you're not alone. Just reach out your hands when you're face to face in a new embrace. Then the pain is gone, 'cause you're not alone. Do you feel the beat talking to your feet? Do you wanna dance? Just reach out your hands when you're face to face in a new embrace. Then the pain is gone.
And now here is Air Force Sergeant Chuck Causey with a few words about the United States Air Force.
Thank you, Connie. You know, time is too precious to waste, and your future may depend on how you plan and use your time. One of the best time investments you can make is college. If you'd like to get started on your college, why not consider the Community College of the Air Force? Through it, you can earn credit for your Air Force technical schools. Plus, when you register for off-duty courses at colleges and universities, the Air Force will pay up to 3/4 of your tuition costs. The Air Force also offers you an excellent salary, a job in one of more than 100 modern career fields, valuable work experience, worldwide assignments, 30 days vacation with pay each year, free medical and dental care, and a secure future. It's one of the finest opportunities in the nation. So if you're concerned about how to manage your time, get in contact with an Air Force time professional. Contact your local Air Force recruiter today. The Air Force, a great way of life.
If you can't believe in love, you can't believe in anything.
another beautiful song from Connie Eaton. And Connie, as usual here, when I have somebody that can sit here and rap a little bit, and especially for good looking, I don't want them to leave, we run out of time.
It's too bad.
I know.
But ask me back.
Country Music Time was recorded live in Nashville, Tennessee, and was brought to you by your local Air Force recruiter and this radio station. Technical direction by Pete Frankette. Engineering by Al Gore. This is Air Force Sergeant Chuck Hawsey saying thanks again to Connie Eaton and reminding you to contact your local Air Force recruiter to get more details about the Air Force, a great way of life.